Very good morning, my dear students. Today I will going to discuss about the program on Python Panda. So Python Panda programming, let's see what is the programming there that we will going to discuss, that data visualization using the matplot and data frame variance. Okay, so data frame variance means what? There we will have some calculations there, and based on that calculations, what we can see that we can have the data frame that we are taking. That means data structures that we are taking, and taking those data structures, how we are finding out the variance of the data structures, that is to be implemented, and how we can implement it. Let's see in the program. Now let's see this particular program. In this particular program, what you can find that I have used here the mathematical calculations. What mathematical calculations? The algebraical expressions that has been used here. So these the algebraical expressions that we find that has been implemented here. In this particular algebraical expression, what we can find that it has been given x into 2 using from the line chart. So we are importing our modules that we what we are using. That means first we are what we are doing, we are importing the modules. What are the modules there? That these the particular modules that we are importing here. So import matplotlib.pyplot. Okay, import matplotlib.pyplot as plt. So as we are importing that particular section, as we are importing that part, we find it that how the structures can be framed, or how can we make this particular structure. The first and foremost what we have done, so I have called here the matplot. Okay, import matplot from where? From the pyplot system. So from the pyplot system, as we are importing that, we find it that we are going to have this particular structures. We are going to construct that particular structures where we are importing this particular matplot as a pyplot system. Okay, then what we can find it, that import numpy as np. So next I have called here the numpy program. Okay, next I have called here the numpy. So why for numpy? Let's see what is the use of numpy is here. So first we are creating the vectors. Okay, vectors of x, y. What is the x and y vectors is there? First x, what we say, numpy array. That means since I have called here an array, array is a function itself, and in this function what we require, an np, because without np we cannot call the array. So therefore we have taken here the numpy. Okay, we have taken here the numpy. So as we have taken here the numpy, next what we have find it, that range is what? Range, we say it, range is up to 100. Our 100 means what? It will going to do up to 0 to 99, isn't it? 0 to 99 the particular value will be taken. So after that, what you can see, there are the y value that has been derived. In the y value, what is derived there? That y equals to x into 2. Into 2 means that what is the value of x? That has been multiplied with 2. Okay, so that has been multiplied with 2. So as we find it, that this is the particular thing that we have, this is the particular part that we have here, that we are constructing with this particular type of what? Particular pattern of the value that has been given here. Now what has been given here, you see, pie plot x comma y, label what has been given, y equals to x into 2. That means what is the value of y? That has been given there, isn't it? Next, what has been given here? It has been given here the title. Then what you can find here, you see here in this particular area, what has been given, we have added the x level and y level. So plt.x level, what has been given here, x axis. plt.y level, y axis. Now I have given the grid. How the grid has been given, see, PLT.grid alpha, that means in an alpha pattern, equals to 0.4, and line style, what is given? One dash green, that. Okay, legend has been given here, plt.legend, and show in the plot graph plt.show. So this is the thing what we can see, this is the thing what you can find, that when we are constructing this particular structure, when we are making this particular structure, we find it that all this particular structure what is there, all this particular part what is there, so each of the part will going to have its different type of what. Okay, has a different type of work. So see here, all the section I have divided here, and I have given the heading of here, so that for further of your use for the different program, you can easily take the reference from here, you can remember the thing and you can use it. So how the thing has been used? First and foremost, again I am saying that first we have called the two header file, that means what we are importing our modules, these are the modules by the using of which we can do the work. Okay, importing the modules, by the help of the modules, that how we can work on it and how we can make the work to be applicable. So import matplotlib.pyplot, that means what we are calling, we are calling here the pyplot. Pyplot is working under what? Under the matplotlib. Okay, pyplot is working under matplotlib, so under the matplotlib module, what is that? PLT, that import numpy as np, then we are calling the numpy here, numpy has been called here what? In the form of an np. Okay, next what we can find it, x equals to np.array, that means what is the vector array we are taking? Range is 100. You say you have seen it previously also, that when we declare a range means what? It will start from 0 and till how much we have given, before of that it will going to show the particular word. Okay, so though it run up to that much, but before of that it will going to show the particular work. Now what will be the then a y value? Y value have some given some equation. What is the equation? X into 2 asterisk 2 means x will be multiplied with that. So this is the power of 2 that we are getting the variance of it. So as we are having this particular area, we can find here that here what we are doing, we are making the values, and first and foremost that adding the title. So first creating the plot, how to create a plot? plt.plot. So what the plot? X comma y, label name is what given? X equals to y equals to x in asterisk 2, isn't it? Then what we find, that add a title, we are adding the title here. In this particular title you see it, some name has been given in the title. Next you find it that there is an x and y label. So for x label and y label, what has been given? PLT x label. Okay, PLT x level what? X axis. PLT y level, y axis. After that what you can find? Grid. Grid has been given, say plt.grid alpha equals to 0.4, that what is the width of it, and line style is what? One, this pattern of dash. Clear? Now legend has been given for it, plt.legend and plt.show. So this is what the thing has been done, this is how we can find it, that we can implement all this particular area and we can work on this particular area. Clear? So this is how we can see, this is how we can find it, that as we are constructing the structures, as we are making the structure, we can find this particular structures will going to do the work and can implement the work in this particular area in this particular way. So let us see then from here what is the output that we can get from it. Okay, so let us see the output of it. Now see the particular output of it. What is the output that we can find it here? In this particular output you can see, as per the variance we have taken, that the dash y equals to x into 2. So this is the particular thing, and based on that what we can find it, that the value has been plotted. So as we find it, that greeting has been done, see small dashes are there. So those the dashes has been created for the greeting purpose, isn't it? So as the dashes has been created for the greeting purpose, we say what is the name has been given. This is an x axis and this one is an y axis. So based on this particular thing, as you move the cursor, you can see how the value are changing. That means based on the value of the particular x to be multiplied and to the power that we can find it, that we are working on it and we are implementing this particular area. Okay, so this is how you can see, this is how you can find it, that you can work on this particular area. And in this particular area, we are having a structures that we are creating it here, and we are making it here to make the structures very much implementable. Okay, so what is the logic that has been given? Based on that logic, what we are doing, we are implementing it and we are working with it. Okay, so let's see the next program, what is there. Now see the next program here. In this particular program, what you can see, the particular program has been done in the base, what we can say, that it is a data frame that has been constructed for it. Okay, so data frame has been constructed. So what has been imported here? It has been imported import pandas as pd, okay, and import numpy as np. So import pandas as pd and import numpy as np. So when we are having this particular thing, when we are making this particular structure, in this particular structure, what we can find, that we will going to construct this particular structures and we will going to make the particular structure. Okay, so this is the structure what we can find, this is the structure what we can see, that each of this particular structure, what is there? First, what we are importing here, we are importing here pandas. Okay, we are importing here the Python pandas, and when we are importing the Python pandas, this the Python panda will going to create the panda framing. Okay, panda as pd and we are calling here numpy as np. Now in this particular area, you can see here that in this particular area, we have what? We have a different type of the structures that we have designed it. Okay, we have designed it. So this the designing, what we can find, that first I have taken one d, and in this particular d, what has been given in the particular d, you see here that d, first the name has been given here. Okay, different type of names has been given here in this particular area. So in this particular area, what we find it, that those the names are there, and in this particular name, some of the different pattern of names has been given. Next, what has been taken here, next the thing has been taken here is a score. Suppose see here, one score panel has been taken, that means one score data series has been taken. Next one has given score 2 data series, and next one has been given score 3 data series. That means what we can find here, that we do have there, we are having a particular data series, and in this particular data series, what we are constructing and what we are making it, we are framing that particular structures and we are working on the structures. Now what we can find it, df equals to pd dot data frame. Okay, df equals to pd dot, that means what we are calling pd. Pd means panda, that means we are calling a panda. So panda, what we are calling the panda for? To create a data frame. That means for a data frame, what we require? We require a panda function, so panda program that is to be implemented. So in this particular structure that we are creating it here, in this particular structure, what you can find it here, that we have some name. Isn't it? The structures has been given D. After that, what we find it, that we have some name there. Clear? So when the name has been given, after this particular name, what is there? There is a score. Okay, there is a score, score 1, score 2, score 3. So all these things are been given in this particular area. All these things has been given in this particular part. So as you have given this particular area or particular part, so those the particular sections what we can find, those the particular part that we can find, that that is been working and that has been imported in this particular frame. That means you see here that a series, three series of numbers and one series of characters. okay, combinations of one series of characters has been taken. So as we can find those characters and combinations of this particular structures, what is there, that they are being worked and they are being implemented in this particular area, and we are getting the structures and we are working on this particular scenario. Okay, now as we are finding it, that we have taken the structures and we have framed the structures, in this particular structures we are making the particular word, and we are making it to be worked with a different type of data. Now df equals to pd dot data frame. Okay, pd dot data frame, that pd dot data frame, we will going to have this particular pattern of the data frame. That means this all the d, under the d what we have stored, the name, the score 1, score 2 and score 3, so all this will going to be taken and that will be converted into a data frame. Then what we have done, print df. Okay, next what here has been done here, say, see, print df variance. Variance means what? To find out the mean. Okay, variance of a number, to find out the mean of a number. So variance of what? All the values what are there. So based on that particular value, what you can find it, that the mean will going to be calculated. Okay, so let's see, this particular mean, when we calculate, we will going to get some particular pattern of output there, and we will going to have that particular output to be working with it. Okay, so those the output what we find, those the output part that we find, that each and every output section what is there, they will going to have this particular structures. So let's see what is the output that will going to work on this particular area. So in this particular area, you see here what we have in this particular frame or in this particular structures. So in this particular structure, what you can see here, that the name, score 1, score 2, score 3 is there, and based on the values has been arranged. You know this is due to the placing problem, and due to this particular placing problem, what we will going to have, we will going to have the structures that will be going to implement in this manner, isn't it? So as the structure will going to take the part, as the structure will going to have this particular type of work, so based on this particular pattern of work, it will going to have the structures in this way, isn't it? So when you are having a structures in this way, when we are framing the structures in this way, so those the particular pattern, those the particular way of making the structures, what it is been done as part the value that has been given, number one. Number two is that you can see here 0 1 2 3 4, if you in the data frame we know it, that by default what it will going to come, it will going to come the default indexing will going to come. Okay, so this is the default indexing. In this particular default indexing, what you can find it from 0 to 11, that means all total 12 value is there. Okay, all total there is a 12 value. Now what I said, variance, that means to be calculated, how many? 12. That means those the value of score 1 is added, and that is divided by 12, and approximate value to the floating point number what it get, it will going to reveal that one. Similarly in the second case, second score also, similarly in the third case also. So we can find it that this the particular thing, this the particular work what is there, that will going to implement in this way, and they will going to make the structures, and they will going to frame the structures so that we can find it, that how the data can be implemented and how we can work on this particular data structure. Okay, so as we are working on this particular data structures, we find it that those the data structures what we are doing, we are using the variance of a number. Okay, the variance of a number, as we are getting, that means mean, median, mode, that mean pattern we are calculating here. That means as you say variance, as you have given the variance, it will calculate by it, the means will be calculated. Okay, so the means will be calculated, and calculating the mean, what we can find it here, that particular data will be executed here. Okay, so you can see here the score 1, score 2 and score 3, the variance value has been shown here. Variance means the mean value of the particular thing. So as you part the curriculum that we have to calculate the mean, median and mode, so this is what the mean has been calculated using just calling the variance. You can calculate it, else you can calculate with a mean or a median function also. Okay, so that also I am going to show you, but this is what the way that we can calculate the particular data structures. And as we can calculate the structures, we can find out that from the data frame or the data structures, what you say in this particular data structures, what we are having here, we are having here the value of the data that we are calculating and that we are working with. Okay, so we are working with and we are calculating with this particular pattern on the structures, and we are implementing those particular pattern of the structure. Clear? So this is what our particular work is, and in this particular pattern or in this particular way we are implementing the function of the particular program. So previous one you have seen that there we have designed one graph. And here you can see that using the variance function, especially what we need to emphasize is using the variance function, we have done it. Okay, so thank you students. Today I am ending today's session here. Thank you all.